beautiful night here in Miami. Can't complain. We live in paradise. We live where you vacation.
Win-win. This is it. This is time. Such a big part of our Miami life here. We'd never have come to Miami or Wynwood if it wasn't for us meeting him in New York. So he brought us here.
The aliens have landed. We're landing and we're making babies.
Met these guys almost 2 years ago in New York City, and
when I saw them, I was like, man, I've never seen no guys like this before. Not really anywhere.
So of course, you know, I went over them, said what's up. They got into my rickshaw, and from there, like, we've just been rolling.
It's been an evolution, but how it first started for Two Square was painting at this hair show, this like world-renowned hair show in New York. It was our first like dance together.
We knew we were gonna do a lot of different stuff, like with the arts, and we wanted to have our hands in everything, but it was just like this stepping off and just like casting away, kind of going out into the wild on our own.
We had all this canvas from the show, so we took it to Central Park in New York, and we would set it out on top of the rocks overlooking, and where there were street artists performing. And it was kind of, I think those moments were the first time we kind of traveled outside of where we left and kind of brought what we do in the studio to the street. And I think it was that we came addicted to that.
Travel and travel until at one point, you know, I was just like, dude, we should go off together and like kind of like do this thing.
And then we went to London soon after that, and we started painting on the street, we started cutting on the street. It was like everything we were doing was kind of out in the open and free and renegade.
Everybody thought we were crazy because we were leaving like a lucrative business and a lucrative position and like nice things and like a guaranteed life. Like we had a set, like, you know, we're on the fast track, we're successful, we're young 20 somethings.
Looking back on it, we would say, fuck man, we would never do that. That's like the dumbest.
We were gonna be here for 3 months and then we were gonna go around the States and travel and paint. We'd always say, yeah, 3 months, we're out of here. And then it got to a point where we were so close to Basel, we had to choose. We either leave for a few months, or we just continued to paint towards our Basel.
Our whole thing, we were gypsy travelers. We didn't expect to be here this long. 6 months passed, yeah, 2 months, we're out of here, and it kept getting longer.
We didn't want to leave.
Had the time of our lives, man, and they saw this was a good place for them to do a lot of what they were already doing.
And since we've been traveling, we've never had a place. And here we've had a place, and we've never been involved in a community quite like this as well.
Not only do you know people, but you know everybody in the street as well. You know, the banker at the Wood, the advertising guy from Ripple, you know, Walter and Troy down the street.
Everybody's looking for an excuse to let loose. What's your locomotive?
Humble as a mumble in the jungle, rough shouts and screams. That's the way the cracker crumbles, so I guess I've got to think about my dreams. Humble as a mumble in the jungle, rough shouts and screams. That's the way the cracker crumbles, so I guess I've got to think about my dreams.
Back on the microphone, your number one controller. I rock the microphone like a blizzard, I'm so cold, I'm trying to told ya. Life is like a great big roller coaster. Everything in life don't always happen like it's supposed to. Try some tribulations, make it stronger, live longer. You wanna reach the nation, nigga, start from your corner. Everything don't always happen like you planned it. Demand it, overstand it, then you handle it. Fuck wishing, you missing the ambition on your mission. Now you switching while you quitting, cause it's heated in the kitchen. Sloppy slipping in your pimpin', nigga. You either pistol whip the nigga or you choke the trigger. You got to follow through, struggle to complete.
It's like, when would it give us opportunity to like define ourselves, to like try different styles, techniques?
When we've lived here, like I've lived here, I've been fucking robbed on these streets. Been fucking bit by dogs. Like, we've been fucking chased by the police.
I went fucking nuts in the city. It's gonna be sad to leave because we felt like nestled into our community. Like, even lately, we've seen like the rise of some of the locals around there. We can honestly say that we have contributed to that.
Because that's been a part of us. It's like everything's been growing together.
You know, wherever we go from here, you know, this was it. You know what I mean?
All right, now, don't judge me on this. I try not to, like, be here too much. It's mad messy in here. We got it in Tennessee. It's been luxury since. This love, what professional I am. It's a little ghetto right now. I mean, it's always ghetto, but it's extra ghetto right now. How long have I been living in this space? A little over 2 years. Before that, was in a van in Europe. Yeah, it's kind of snarly in here, but I just basically sleep here. I try not to be around here. I don't hang out for any amount of time during the day in this space. So it's like I clean it and it gets pretty fucked up quick. This is where maybe a little bit of magic happens. So I don't know. Leisure. Luxury, glamour, flashy lights. 'Cause everything you've been through made you stronger. And every day you learn about yourself. And nothing really played out how it's supposed to. Depending on somebody else as well. But now you know the value of a dollar. And girl, I make enough of it to spend. I love the way you put yourself together. I love the way you make that body bend for me again. Oh, yeah. I love you, love this love. What professional I am. You know, we're sophisticated.
Miami is the kind of place that's like old Paris or like maybe modern Berlin, where you can just set up shop and just take over if you're hungry and you want to do it, because the lifestyle is slow enough, but there's enough opportunity there that you can kind of like take a vacation for a while as an artist. And that's what I love about it. Every time I come home, there's just a feeling you can't get anywhere else. 'Cause your freedom was here
in this cage all along. Yeah, I was living with my girl in the design district. Now I'm here. I'm living in Sean's world, Spider-Man's cave.
If you were just gonna make that leap of faith and just go all out and get into what you're comfortable in, other people are gonna gravitate towards you and wanna know, like, what's up, what you got going on. So that's just another way of expressing yourself with how you dress and how you walk and how you swing.
My bedroom and my living room. This is my clothing rack, my closet. I'm back eating bird food. So it's like my reality's checked right before I go to Europe.
There's too many people that have helped us that do great things to even think about doing something with somebody that's, you know, not been cool with us the whole time.
It's been an honor to be here and be part of this pivotal time of Wynwood, I think, when it's on the cusp of becoming something greater, losing its innocence. A lot of buildings are getting knocked down, a lot of businesses are coming out, putting glass windows in, and you're going to see that after we leave.
For the last year and a half, we've been here, which, you know, the airport is right there. Every plane that takes off goes this way. So every day, imagine like getting teased. it's like being a traveler, being a gypsy, and seeing like hundreds of planes fly over you every day while you paint. So it's like every single one, man, like people are walking by. I'm not thinking about these motherfuckers. I'm thinking about the planes. And the whole time we've been saying, man, next time we get on a plane, it's gonna be deserved. Like, we've earned it. And I swear to fucking God, we've fucking earned it. It's a different feeling, you know, from like, we're so close.
It's the road that you lived and the decisions that you made. And I'm pretty cool where I'm at right now. I'm happy. We're in a good spot. We're about to kick some major ass.
We want to say bon voyage! We love you. Best of luck. Amazing. Make some stories for us.
We're getting to a point now where people see that we're not going anywhere. Like, we're pushing harder. And people are like, well, you know, these guys are going somewhere. And yeah, these guys are hustling. These guys are producing. I think just people are starting to just take notice that it's not just, you know, long hair, don't care. There's like a mentality, there's a hustle about it.
Yeah, it's a lifestyle.
Yep. It's a brand that he and I are on. They're watching us do it like ground level. Yeah. And what it's gonna be, they're gonna look back and say, damn, Two Square was too legit to quit.
It's one of the things about traveling, you always have to leave in some way.
Feel like what it looks like.
I think our whole evolution in mind and our journeys have brought us to like where you see us right now.
It's been a pleasure and an honor to be here.
Yeah, it's been an evolution to get here. Man.
I appreciate those of you that follow our artwork and have seen our evolution and you recognize it and you follow it and you appreciate it because I appreciate you.
The main run is never like the practice run.
Been planting a lot of seeds. It's about time to bear that fruit.